So this week I got to help a celebrity surprise their husband. So Eliana secretly messaged me and asked me to do a drawing to surprise her husband for their wedding anniversary. So of course I said I'm in. The drawing she wanted me to do was kind of themed around their wedding, which was fairy meets knight in shining armor. So of course I started drawing right away. I loved this concept and I felt like such a ninja just sneaking around doing drawings without people's husbands knowing. But anyway, since their wedding theme was fairy meets knight in shining armor, of course I turned her into a fairy and him into a knight in shining armor. This drawing took about 8 hours and it was so, so much fun. This is what it looks like, and I even got Eliana to record her husband's reaction. And this is what they thought.
Wow, so pretty.
Isn't it pretty? Look at my wing!
I know, that's crazy.
And she made you her armor.
I know!
Let's draw another celebrity that specifically asked me to draw them. So Kyle Thomas reached out to me the other day. He really, really wanted to be drawn. He has 21.9 million followers. And I kind of freaked out a little bit, and then I had a great idea. Since I've been watching Rise of the Guardians lately, I really wanted to turn him into Jack Frost. I thought this would be such a good idea for a drawing, since Jack Frost is pretty much everyone's favorite character. If you disagree, go ahead, comment, tell me who your favorite character is. But anyway, I spent all day drawing and this is how it turned out. I love this drawing. It took about 5 to 6 hours. And I love how it turned out. Kyle, I really, really hope you like this. Everyone tag him in the comments. And if you want to see me draw more celebrities that specifically asked me to draw them, make sure you hit that follow button and I will see you all in the next video. Okay, bye. Let's draw someone who's not famous for a change, because I've been drawing a lot of celebrities lately. So I scrolled through my comments randomly and I found this girl, Emily. And of course I messaged her and asked her what she wanted me to draw her as, and she really, really wanted me to draw her as Anna from Frozen. I looked through her TikTok to find a reference image and to know what her face looked like. And then I just started drawing right away. My inspiration for this drawing was kind of like that scene from Frozen 2 when Anna is in the ice cave. And she sings that beautiful song, The Next Right Thing. Oh my gosh, I cried during that scene. But anyway, this is what it looks like. I hope you guys like it as much as I do. Please tag Oh It's Ems in the comments. And Emily, I can't wait to see what you think. Let's draw another celebrity because they specifically asked that I draw them part 4. Americana commented on one of my videos recently. He really wanted to be drawn. Merrick is most well known for his robotic style dancing. And he was even on America's Got Talent for it. And this gave me a really, really good idea. So I scrolled through his Instagram to find a reference photo and decided to turn him into a cyborg, which is like a futuristic kind of robot. I feel like this suits Merrick really well because his dance style is very robotic and is all about robotic style movements. So I thought Merrick would really, really love this. Not gonna lie, this was a very, very complicated drawing and it took me all day, but I think it all paid off. This is what it looks like. I love this drawing and I hope you guys do as well. Merrick, if you're watching, I really, really hope you like this drawing. Everyone tag him in the comments and I can't wait to see his reaction. Let's draw another famous person because they specifically asked that I draw them. Liana commented a while ago, she has 3.7 million followers and she really wanted me to draw her. I've been following her for so long, so I was super excited to do this. I always message my celebrities and ask if they want me to draw them as anything specific. She wanted me to draw her as Ariel, so of course I lit my Disney themed candle. And I started drawing right away, and I decided to draw her in this green dress that Ariel has. Kind of coming out of the sea as if it's the end of the first movie, you know, when Ariel walks majestically out of the water. So yeah, this is what it looks like. Everyone please tag Eliana in the comments. Eliana, I really, really hope you like it and I can't wait to see your reaction. Let's draw someone famous again because they asked me to. Jack reached out to me the other day. He has 3.6 million followers. I've been following him for ages. And I asked him what he wanted me to draw him as and he said something Star Wars. And I had such a good idea. I've been binge watching the Mandalorian series like crazy. And so I found this reference picture of Jack. I decided to turn him into the Mandalorian or have like a Mandalorian inspired drawing. I was super nervous because all of the post-credit drawings in the Mandalorian series are just so good and I was like, how am I going to compare? But I had so much fun drawing this, so this is how it came out. Everyone tag Jack in the comments. But yeah, this is what it looks like. I hope you guys enjoy it, and if you want to be drawn yourself, all you have to do is follow and comment and then I might draw you. Okay, bye! Let's draw someone famous again because they specifically requested it. So I got a comment from CJ, who's a really popular TikToker at the moment. He was wanting me to draw him and I got super excited because I've been following him for like ages. I messaged him to find out what character he wanted me to draw him as because I usually draw people's characters, and he surprised me, and since I've been watching a lot of The Legend of Korra lately, I wanted to turn him into Marco. So I made sure I included Marco's scarf, I made sure all the costuming was correct, I made like even firebending, and it was overall just super fun. I really enjoyed this drawing. CJ, I really hope you like it. I don't know if you watched The Legend of Korra, but even if you don't, I still hope you like it. Everyone tag him below, and if you watched The Legend of Korra, let me know what your favourite character is in the comments, because I want to find some other people who like the show. Okay, so I'm a digital artist, and the other day I was just lying down relaxing, you know, as you do, and then I saw this very attractive photo of Cole Sprouse, very, and then I started thinking, he kind of looks like Flynn Rider, I don't know why, but he just does. And then I had the mind-blowing idea of turning him into Flynn Rider for a drawing video, and I was just like, yeah, I'm gonna do this. So, yeah, I got out my iPad and pen, and I did it, I sketched it. I had a lot of fun just looking at his very attractive face for hours on end. And this is what I came up with. I hope you guys like it as much as I do, because it looks hot. So I'm a digital artist. Lately I've been doing a drawing series of turning celebrities into Among Us characters, and I needed to do Yellow next, and I was looking up reference photos and I was like, who am I going to turn into Yellow? And then I saw this picture of Cameron Boyce and I got so sad. But I was like, if I'm going to draw anyone as the Yellow Among Us avatar, it's going to be Cameron Boyce. So yeah, I spent all day sketching and this is what I came up with. I also included quotes of what I think he would say as both crew and imposter. So yeah, this is what I came up with. I hope you guys like it. Shawty gon' get that paper. Shawty don't rip like razor. Shawty got wig, got flavor. Part of my tits and makeup. Pay her. Jump in and hit that layup. Shawty ain't with them. So I'm a digital artist, and check out this awesome transition. I spent ages on it. Anyway, today I was just scrolling through TikTok and I came across this video, and I feel like everyone's seen it. And for some reason I was like, what would this girl look like as a Disney princess? Anyway, so I started sketching right away and giving her the Disney features. And then halfway through, I was like, damn, this is super easy. What if she's like actually a Disney princess and no one knows? Anyway, so yeah, I gave her like a blue flower crown and like this blue ball gown thing. So this is how it came out. What if she's actually a princess, guys? Like, serious question. Like, what if? So I'm a digital artist, and today I woke up to find out that Jordan Fisher commented on the video that I did of him as a Ravenclaw. And so I started freaking out, and then I found out he's in a movie with Sabrina Carpenter. And I was like, I have to do a drawing for Sabrina Carpenter as well. And she's on TikTok, so if enough people tag her, she might see it. Yeah, I started drawing right away, and I've also been obsessed with the Airbender series, so I decided to make her a firebender, or my take on what she would look like as a firebender. So yeah, this is what it looks like. Please, please, please tag her, and then she might see it. So yeah, this is the final product. Sabrina Carpenter, if you're watching, I hope you like it. So I'm a digital artist, and the other day Jordan Fisher saw the drawing I did of him, and so I decided to draw a drawing for Sabrina Carpenter because she's in a movie with him. I drew her as a firebender and everyone really seemed to like it, so I decided to make it a series and do waterbending next. And someone said Zendaya should be an avatar, and I was like, yes, this would be perfect for waterbending. So I decided to start drawing right away. And the more I drew, the more I realized she kind of looks like Katara from The Last Airbender, which is super cool. So yeah, this drawing was super fun. So this is what Zendaya would look like if she was a waterbender. Unfortunately, I don't think Zendaya is on TikTok, but if you send it to her on other platforms, she might see it. So I'm a digital artist, and lately I've been doing a drawing series of turning celebrities into avatar benders, and so far I've done Zendaya and Sabrina Carpenter, and I wanted to do earthbending next. And I was like, who am I going to turn into an earthbender? And someone said Tom Holland, and I was like, yep, okay, yep, do that, because I might have a slight obsession with him. Anyway, so started drawing right away, and this was really fun, but it wasn't until halfway through that I realized someone else commented that I should do Dwayne The Rock Johnson as the earthbender, because he's The Rock. Get it? The Rock. So I cried about that for about 5 minutes, but then I pushed on and I finished the drawing. And so yeah, this is what Tom Holland would look like as an earthbender. Unfortunately, I don't think he's on TikTok, but send it to him on other platforms and you might see it.
Too much.